Little pick and roll. Oh! He caught a body, and it was Embiid at the other end.
Every year, there is a handful of players that catch us all by surprise. Athletes that have become all-stars seemingly overnight. It makes the game interesting to see an athlete no one would even give a second look to turn into a household name. In the past few years, we've seen athletes like Giannis, Luka, Jokic go from unknown or pure speculation to conference-defining players in a very short time. It might seem obvious now in retrospect, but if we take a look back 5 years and take Giannis for example, you could find hundreds of articles doubting what the then 20-year-old was capable of, and many even calling him a flat-out bust. I was going to make a top 5 or even a top 10, but since I had the number 1 in mind regardless, I figured we'd just dive a bit deeper. Keep in mind, this is my opinion, although I do feel he may well go down as the NBA's most underrated player this year, I am very open to other suggestions, which might even be the next video. Regardless, let me know down in the comments who you guys think deserves more recognition. So, before I lay out the step-by-step case for why Domantas Sabonis is the 2020 NBA season's most underrated player, if you haven't already and you enjoy this type of content, drop a like. If you guys want to reach out, hit that link below, let's have a conversation, I'm always responding within 24 hours. And finally, hit that subscribe button for weekly content just like this. Alright, back to the video.
This afternoon, the Pacers, Domantas Sabonis agreeing to a new 4-year deal can make up to $80 million.
Indiana was forced to have to make something happen, and I guess they felt this was the best they could do.
The more I look at this deal, the more my mouth drops open about it.
That's a home run for Oklahoma City, regardless of whether he stays or not.
In the 2017 trade that would send Paul George to OKC, the Pacers would receive Oladipo, who went to college in Indiana, which was thought to bring more fans to the games. Oladipo at that point was averaging 16 points per game. Oh yeah, Domantas. He was also a part of that trade deal with Victor, but at the time, like you just saw, this was thought to be a terrible trade, and it would receive a heavy amount of scrutiny. Of course, over time, every last one of these critics would be proven wrong as Sabonis has risen the ranks and proven how good he truly is. But even still, I don't think NBA fans or the media has got the full sense of the gravity of his talent. So who has the highest points rebounds per game combo? This guy. Okay, but a close second is Domantas. Real quick, what this means is he has the 5th most rebounds in the league per game currently, hovering right around 13 per game. And of those 4 athletes higher, Giannis is the only one with more points per game. Domantas is currently averaging 18.3 points, 12.5 rebounds, and 5 assists with the Pacers, who are also doing pretty good. A team I find to be underrated as well, but we'll save that for another video. Regardless, Domantas is putting up solid numbers, but really not going to turn too many heads. However, when we look at the trend that's taken place over the past few years, he's roughly doubling his rebounds and points per game, year after year, consecutively for 4 years. And this is of course on top of the obvious improvements he's making outside of the stat sheet, the most apparent aspect being his basketball IQ. He's an exceptional playmaker, arguably the best screen setter in the league, currently first overall in screen assists, and he knows how to find an open man as well, averaging 5 assists per game, which is 36th overall and 4th when only factoring players over 6'8". As I'm sure some of you are aware, Sabonis was an all-star this past year. However, the group was littered with former MVPs, MVP candidates, all-NBA selections, and ultra-high usage players. And then, Domantas, a very unlikely candidate, who arguably can be any of these things, but chooses to be equally efficient, just in a much more quiet, subtle, and ultimately less marketable way, hence him being underrated. But when we take a look at the 4 All-Stars with a lower usage rating than Sabonis, they are all much more likely to try to score as opposed to finding a scoring opportunity for someone else, further proving his unselfishness. Essentially, the Pacers' offense runs through Sabonis very efficiently and doesn't require him for the finished product. Sabonis's four-year extension made in late 2019 was worth nearly $80 million and is generally regarded as a good deal for both Sabonis and the Pacers, especially when you compare it to the one made 2 years prior. In this regard, the Pacers are able to test out the pairing of Miles Turner and Sabonis further, which at this moment seems to be working seamlessly. The Pacers have won 6 of their last 7 games, which also allowed DeMontis to record his 50th double-double of the season, a new franchise record. Sabonis seems to be a test as to if an old-school big fundamental, you could even draw parallels to Tim Duncan, can exist in today's league. Sabonis's game is airtight, it's fundamentally sound, his IQ is relatively unmatched, and this all sums up to the media's definition of boring. What I'm trying to say is he's not going to win the dunk contest anytime soon, but who cares? I could easily see a title in his future. His dad, Arvidas, is actually a very impressive athlete as well. A Hall of Famer, as a matter of fact. He played professionally for over 20 years, a long career for someone who stands at 7'3". It's too early to predict or even insinuate Hall of Fame potential for the young DeMontis, but the reason I bring that up is because, similar to his dad, a quiet, overlooked, big, fundamental center, he could sneak his way into the elite ranks of the NBA before anyone saw it coming. Whether that be a championship this year, the next, or something as simple as a continuously consistent, dominant presence in the post, it's worth at least asking ourselves, who is this guy? Videos getting released every Friday. Thank you guys for watching. If you enjoyed, drop a like. It's your favorite coach's favorite editor. Peace.